I knew this would happen to my car eventually, the notorious Tesla Model S door handle microswitch problem. Let's get to work. Window down, trim off. Following some other video's advice, unscrew the top nut holding the handle. There she is, hiding in a weird place. Also following the advice, tape over the handle with masking tape, keep it snug, as sticking out pieces might be catching. Flat 10mm will do the job. Keep the magnet close. You don't want a nut to fall and get the window cracked or scratched, or go fishing for it for an hour later. A small flathead screwdriver helps to take off the inner door screw covers. I believe this was 10mm socket behind the top door handle. And Torx 30 behind the opener lever. Pull the inner door trim towards yourself firmly around, piece by piece. That's funny, one cable not connected to anything. Take some pictures, as it's not obvious to reconnect them back. Carefully disconnect all the cables, trying not to break any tabs. Also, door pull lever cable needs to be detached. Clearly, I'm not the first one to open that. This hanger off door trim. Very smart, whoever's idea it was. And these are not the original hole plugs. Another small Torx opens the big panel, giving access to mechanisms. Another three nuts holds the door handle in place. Where is the third one hiding? Ah, here! A 10mm socket with quite long extension will solve this step. A screwdriver, or longer key, will fool the door into thinking it's shut closed. This will move the window all the way up, giving you more space to maneuver the door handle assembly out of there. It takes some wiggling and time, especially to get it off the top screw. Door handle is out. Carefully detach the connector from inside the door. Take a picture, or remember how the cable was routed. You want to place it back the same way later on. You don't want the window going down to catch it and create a big problem. Let's open it up and see the damage. Little bit of rust, but gear looks okay. Can't say the same about the wires going to microswitches, completely oxidized and breaking when touched. There is also some loose screw flying around, huh? I'm not sure what gen this handle is, probably 2.1, but could also be gen 1, 2, 2.5 or 3 in your car. All the gen 2 shares the same prone to failure components. Gen 1 is more problematic, and gen 3 supposed to be bulletproof. I bought this repair kit for around 20 euros from AliExpress, as I didn't know what else would need replacing. There is one more microswitch top mounted over the gear, I believe an end stop for the motor. I wonder, if this one fails, then motor gonna try to pull too far and break the gear. I'd like to replace this one too, but it's not included in the repair kit. Okay, microswitches and harness have been changed, but now, I'm trying to figure out what's above the motor. Where are these three cables broke off from? AI suggested some light source. I think it's a sensor. No idea for sure. Time to tidy up the wires and get one more thing sorted. Terrible squeaky spring. It's gone. Such a relief now. Time to put the cover back, to connect the door cable and test it out. Make sure the door is fooled into closed. It works super, even with this mystery element disconnected inside. Now, I will try to install it back inside the door. Make sure handle is hidden and disconnect the cable. It wasn't the easiest task. It took many back and forward to get the alignment right, and it turned out that the depth changed after removing mystery element before. I quickly tested if it's working correctly, but I had to take it out again. The screw to adjust depth of the handle is in the middle of the back cover. Depth is more or less okay, so I need to make gap alignment perfect straight. Make sure the door handle cable is routed correctly inside the door, and I can start putting the door back together. I should order two repair kits, snip the cables and replace the third microswitch too. I might need to do this job again someday. match connectors, connect all the electrical cables back together, and remember about the door opening lever cable. Make sure the stop piece with the window inner seal is aligned on the door as shown here, before attaching main door trim panel. This makes it way easier to put the door panel on the door again. I should really do that after aligning the handle. Put the funny last stop nut back in its place. A magnet holder, screwdriver and a flat 10mm did the job. Torque it properly. Put door panel screws back in and window seal trim piece. Done! Success! Doors are working as they should again. Thank you for watching and see you next time.